Radio is sponsored by Netflix.
What's up, everybody? Good morning, good afternoon. I am so excited to be filming all of these different DIYs. We all know I personally love DIYs, but before we get on to this video, I have a very special announcement. There's a new show called Julie and the Phantoms. Super cute show, super awesome. I personally really like it.
Julie and the Phantoms is now streaming only on Netflix, so come watch.
All right, we're gonna have a little bit of a chit chat. I kinda wanted to talk a little bit more on why I personally love doing these DIYs, doing these crafts. I feel like sometimes it can be a stress reliever. Sitting down and finding some type of cool design and then creating that and seeing it come to life is super fun, super cool to me. One thing I actually did was I actually created my own product. You guys probably have heard of it, my Claylea choker. It was so exciting to see this end up coming to life, seeing it go from on a piece of paper, just a drawing, and then becoming a real necklace, something that everyone buys, something that everyone loves, and I can see other people wearing it. You have no idea how exciting it made me feel. It made crafts seem even more fun to me. These DIY items are a little bit like that. Obviously, I can't exactly sell them. It is personalized things that I have done to these ordinary, normal jeans, shirts, sweatpants, and I find little tiny designs, cute little things to add onto them to make them personalized and my own personal boutique. Just kidding, not boutique, but something that's very personalized for me. They do that exact same thing in Julie and the Phantoms. All the characters in that show all have very personalized clothing to their personalities. Little tiny jewels, butterflies, ribbons, whatever it is that fits their personality, they have on their outfits. And I think that's so cool. And that is basically what we're gonna be doing today. I'm gonna show you guys a few ways to personalize your own clothing. So, let's just get straight onto the video. Running from the past. First DIY, we have some jeans, some embroidery floss, and some needles. First DIY, which is this right here. We are going to be basically embroidering the pockets, like the seam of the pocket, and then doing like some flowers, like they're coming out of the pockets. I'll probably do that on the front too, and then the back too. We will just put some embroidery on it. Anyways, let's get started. I'm gonna kind of make it really long just so that we don't like run out of pieces, you know, like better safe than sorry, that whole thing.
Look at that, oh my gosh, almost there. Go, go, go.
I did it! Now we're going to, well, get started, I guess. And I'm gonna start by moving the jeans to the side. We're just gonna go right on the edge of these seams that are already in the jeans. So we can kind of measure through that and just pull right on through. Oh, well, kind of. Sometimes you gotta leave. Look how cute that is! To get a little help until we find our way. I believe. So one reason why I really love to do these DIYs and to upcycle old clothes is, first of all, you are not wasting clothes, some good clothes. You know, using what you have and creating something new, some new style. And speaking of new style, I love that when I make DIY pieces, it's unique to its own self. It's different compared to anyone else's, and it's very unique to myself. I can add a personal touch of like myself, I guess, to it. It's almost just like the show Julie and the Phantoms, how their clothing, they all had unique pieces designed specifically to their personality. It was very personal. I just love how you can get super personal when you're creating your own stuff, when you're DIYing everything. Just like these, no one else is gonna have this exact same thing. And it just makes it's super cool to have your own personal stuff. So far, I think this actually looks quite fantastic. You know, your girl is very proud of her stuff. Look at how cute! And these are actually jeans that I never really would have worn anyways, And so now I am adding a little flair to them and making them basically popular again. We are almost done. We are getting close. We are getting close. It's gonna be exciting when this thing is finished. Okay, I need to stop now. So close to being done. We have this little tiny amount left, and these are looking seriously so adorable. We're gonna get this finished and on to the next one because I am so excited to keep going. Really, all you are doing is you pull it over, so you see it's coming through here. Pull it over and under, and you wanna make sure it's either overlapping the other one, like you can see right here, probably not. You can see it's kinda overlapping it, and then you wanna pull it pretty tight, not super tight, because then it'll end up scrunching this and kinda make it weird. I finished it, and that's the cutest thing in the world. Look at how cute! Guess what you're gonna need? Jeans! And what else are you gonna need?
Some more embroidery floss.
And a needle. Now, today, with these jeans, I am honestly so excited for this one. I think this one's gonna be really cute. We're gonna be doing this right here. We're gonna be adding words onto the jeans, so I'll probably add some maybe right here. Maybe I'll do one like back here. I think I'm gonna use purple first. We're gonna add one that says heartbreaker. We're actually gonna use white for this one. All right, so for starters, since it's gonna be small, we're just gonna be doing small stitches, I guess. And watch out to not poking your finger when you do it, because I just did. So, learn from my mistake. Oh, that's really small. Okay, then you're gonna back stitch a bit, just tiny bit, as you can see, if you can see. I kind of just back stitch just barely. We're gonna go up again. And I am kind of feeling for where, oh, just kidding, I don't have to. I was gonna say, I am feeling for where it is so that I can know to where to stab it, but we didn't need to that time, so we're all good. Okay, we did that. Oh, look how cute! And again, it's all just up to you how you want it to look. These are just the basic stitching that you will do to get that. But it depends on you, what you're feeling. You know, funny thing is, you'd think my mom was the one that taught me how to do this stitch. No, no. It was my dad. He taught me how to do this. Well, he told me like how you're supposed to do it. He didn't teach me because it's not that hard, but yeah, he taught me how to do this. It's kind of crazy. Kind of fun, kind of cool. Okay, we just finished this H, as you can see. We're gonna start on the H and or the E. And actually, I know you're supposed to make some kind of knot. I don't exactly know how to, guys. I'm so sorry, but I am just going to put this little knot in it. So that kind of just secures it, makes sure that it will stay. And then we're just gonna move right on over, not even cutting the string. We're just gonna move right on over. Start with the E. Cute. I like how like vintagey it looks. Not vintagey, but like very handmade. That's also just handmade. And we're left with a little bit of string left. I honestly didn't think I would have any string left, but these are so cute. I actually seriously love those. Okay, we did heartbreaker. Oh, I actually am going to add a couple more things. I added one extra little touch. We got a heart. And in all, look at how cute. It does say heartbreaker. That kind of got in the way, but they're so cute. I love them so much. is number 3. For this one, you're gonna need some jeans, I guess. You're also gonna need some Sharpies, bunch of different colors. We're also gonna need some paintbrushes and paint. We're gonna use these cute jeans. We're actually gonna be flipping them over though. We're just gonna get started. We're just gonna get painting. I'm actually gonna use a few different versions off of Pinterest, kind of go off of those, kind of go off of my own designs. Let's just see where this takes us. We're gonna start with a little bit because, you know, better to have less than more. Well, we got some pink. Obviously, we gotta go with pink. I mean, we all know me. I gotta have my pinks. Ooh, we got some yellow. We need some purple. I think this is purple. Oh, wait, no. This is purple. Okay, red and yellow make orange, right? Is that right? Let's hope I'm right because, wait, yes, I think it is. Goodness, someone needs to go back to school. Well then, got an array of different colors. Now let's just get started, shall we? This one basically done. It kind of looks a little weird. It's not the cream that we were going for, but it'll work. So many brushes, I don't know what to choose from. I think I'll do this one since it is a bigger part. See, it's kind of annoying and kind of hard because there are these like fabric pieces or whatever, ripples. I don't know what you'd call them, but we'll make it work. Ah, it's looking so cute. I'm actually gonna do another like kind of weird like some kind of geometrical thing. And for purple, I think I'm gonna just do some little tiny thing, maybe like a diamond here. I just got number 3 done. How adorable are those? That's freaking cute. Like, can we just talk about that? Look at how cute. We had a little bit of struggles. Okay, guys, I am not like an amazing artist, so don't judge me there, but I think they look so cute. Okay, well, let's get on to the try-on. Okay, everybody, I am on my last one. It's exciting. Everyone be pumped. Woo! Woo! This next one is, of course, ripped jean. Yay! We got ourselves a beautiful pair of nice jeans that we'll be ripping. And we already have the benefit of already having a few rips. Everything you do the entire time. Just, I mean, if you want all these strings, then that's what you do. But if you don't, then you don't have to do that. You can just cut it and like fray the ends. But I want a bunch of strings on the ends, so we take about an hour or so to pull them all apart. It does work a lot with sandpaper. We do not have any sandpaper here, so tweezers work really well too, though. I was using my nails and it was just not working. So we resorted to tweezers. And then also, if they're small enough and loose enough, you can just scrape like this with like the other side, and it'll just pull them kind of out. Or it'll loosen them up and then you can pull them all out pretty easily. So, pretty useful. I've put them on. These ones are obviously still not super frayed, kind of looks a little weird. So we'll just keep working on them But we got this next leg cut, and it looks like I just, well, cut it. So I would normally sandpaper it, but we just cut a bunch of little slits and then pull the strings from there. Basically, you just keep pulling like this. And I think there's a lot of different ways you can fray the jeans, make the jeans and whatever. This video, and I hope some of these crafts gave you some ideas, sparked some inspiration. Let me know in the comments down below which one was your favorite, and if you tried any of these, how they turned out. And be sure to tag me on Instagram so that I can see all of your guys' cute personalized items and some of the things you love to do to your clothing. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to go and check out Julie and the Phantoms on Netflix. Come and watch it. It's gonna be exciting, gonna be super fun. I'm really excited. So make sure to do that, and I will see you guys later. Bye.